Is that coping? And can I ask the medics as well, if we already had the kinds of numbers of tests that you would like to see, how much of a difference would it have made to your ability to fight the disease?
Well, first of all, Laura, on the tests, a huge national program of testing is being rolled out, but I'll hand over to Patrick and to Chris to say a little bit more about testing and how we're going to do it. But on the national effort to protect those whose jobs, whose livelihoods are threatened, I think everybody understands the challenge that the whole country now faces. But we have to get through this together, and we are getting through it together with an unprecedented program of support for not just for businesses, but for workers of all kinds across the country. Never in our history has the government put its arms around people in the way that we are doing now to help them get through this difficult time. And yes, it's absolutely true that the measures to support people in employment are exceptional and extraordinary. 80% of your salary up to £2,500 per month were standing behind. We're also, in the course of the next couple of days, you'll be hearing more from Rishi Sunak, the Chancellor, tomorrow, about what we're doing to help the self-employed. And I think people do understand that the complexity of their working arrangements has meant that it has been harder to come up with the right tailored program for the self-employed as well. But that is coming forward tomorrow. And yes, I do think that when you look at the sheer scale of what the government is doing to get this country through, we will, to answer your question directly, we will cope, and we are coping very well indeed under the most challenging possible circumstances. But the most important thing to enable us to get through it well together and to come out well together, as I think we can, as I know we can, is that we all follow the instructions that the government has given. Stay at home, protect the NHS, and that's the way to save lives. But on testing, perhaps, Chris, would you like to say some more?
In terms of testing, there are a variety of different things you use testing for, some of which we have tests available for and have done throughout, some of which we do not. So I'm going to run through them because they're different answers to depending on which you're talking about. Starting off with the antigen testing, which is testing for people who've currently got a disease. We initially were using that to help screen people who came from high-risk countries. When that ceased to be a sensible policy, we moved on to testing people in intensive cares and in hospitals, and we have sufficient tests for that at the moment. The system for that is working fine and is being scaled up. So that side of testing is in place and is working well. So if a patient gets as far as a hospital, we're confident on the testing and on the scale-up. The thing we would